Good morning, everyone, and welcome to this important briefing. As you all know, the incident at the Baxter Institute involving the Quantum Gate was a tragedy. However, from that tragedy comes opportunity. The DoD was responsible for recovering and rehabilitating the four surviving assets. They all exhibited highly unusual physical attributes, clearly deserving further evaluation. Asset one. Reed Richards. On the left, that is the strongest man-made material, breaking in an extreme tensile strength test. On the right, he stretches but remains unbroken. Clearly, he is far superior to anything we could hope to achieve with years of research costing millions of dollars. In order to harness the power of these assets, we built cutting-edge containment suits. We have since vastly improved these sea suits in both design and function. Asset 2, Sue Storm, exhibits stealth capabilities far superior to the military tech. An entire division of soldiers completely invisible to the naked eye. That's what I call the ultimate covert fighting force. Comparison of Asset 3, Johnny Storm. On the left, you see the thermal imaging for a test subject with normal body temperature. On the right, much hotter, approximately 1,100 degrees Celsius. Imagine producing enough heat to propel yourself through the air and launch bursts of heat more accurately than a top-grade flamethrower. Asset 4, Ben Grimm. On the left, that's the toughest man-made composite being drilled. Asset 4's surface is literally impenetrable. Bulletproof tech is just the tip of the iceberg. For obvious reasons, it was unnecessary to develop a containment suit for Asset 4. We moved quickly from rehabilitation and research to deployment of these assets in controlled combat situations, and the results have far exceeded expectations. Here's a preview of some of their most useful applied ops. Everything you've just seen is the result of untrained civilians with brief exposure inside the Quantum Gate. With trained personnel receiving long-term exposure, the applied ops potential is truly staggering. As you can see, my request for funding to continue this program is not only reasonable, it's requisite. Now let me show you around our facility and introduce you to the department's four greatest weapons of war.